Hello friends and welcome to Unacademy. So today we are going to discuss about the strategy, 6 months strategy to crack UPSC CSE 2021. Let's crack UPSC CSE 2021. So this is a 6 months strategy video. What you have to do in the next 6 months to crack the 2021 UPSC CSE. Welcome to Unacademy, and we are the largest learning platform in India. And before we move on, I would like to tell a little bit about myself and also about Unacademy. So about me, I have done my master's in economics. So for UPSC, mostly I take economics, Indian economy and Indian polity. These are the two subjects that I handle apart from current affairs. So my educational qualification is that I have done my master's in economics, and I also have a 7 years of teaching experience in UPSC, CSE. And for the last 2.5 years, I have online teaching experience, the exclusive online teaching experience. So I have been teaching in various online platforms for the last 2.5 years, and in total 7 years of UPSC teaching experience. And I am Joycey Joy. So this is about myself and regarding Unacademy and the courses that we provide here. So as I was just telling you, hardly 6 more months left for your prelims examination, for the 2021 prelims examination. And considering that we have started a new batch, 2 batches, one is the ultimate GS batch and the other one is the 2021 mission 2021 batch. Both of these batches are 6 months crash course for the UPSC CSE 2021. And in both these batches, we'll be covering 100% syllabus for your prelims examination. The top educators would be handling the sessions. There will also be prelims test series along with the analysis. PDF study material will be given to you. There will be dedicated doubt clearing sessions and interview preparations. And prelims cum mains integrated batch courses. So prelims cum mains integrated batch courses, it will be available for 1 year and 2 years. So for 2022 and 23. These are pre cum mains integrated batches. And we also have this Lakshya program. Lakshya program will be Hindi medium GS classes. So UPSC CSE GS classes, but this will be in Hindi. The medium of instruction will be in Hindi. And this Lakshya program is also available for 6 months, 1 year and also for 2 years. We also have expedition batches. So expedition batches are in English. These are exclusively in English. And these batches are available for 6 months, 1 year and also for 2 years. This is regarding the Iconic price, subscription price. The Iconic price will be increased soon. It will be hiked soon. So you can enroll for Iconic subscription as early as possible. So I'll just brief you the features of Iconic subscription apart from the features that are available on Plus subscription. So whatever are available on the Plus platform, in addition to that, you will be assigned with a personal coach. That is, you will get a mentor for your preparation. There shall be mains test series along with evaluation, customized study planner, study booster sessions, high intensity workshops, daily answer writing and daily content. So you can upgrade to Iconic subscription. And if you are either subscribing for Plus courses or Iconic courses, you can use my referral code. This is Joycey10. So you can use my referral code Joycey10 and you will get an instant 10% discount on the courses to which you subscribe. So an instant of 10% discount will be given to you. And this is regarding the biggest discount of 2020. So it's a combo offer, UPSC, CSE, plus course, plus the optional. It comes at 70,153. Earlier it was 77,000. The Iconic subscription, UPSC, CSE, GS, Iconic subscription, plus the optional. It comes at 88,705. Earlier it was 97,000. And you can again use my referral code Joycey10, Joycy10, for extra 10% off. So over and above what Unacademy is providing, you can use my coupon code. You will get an extra 10% off on the courses. So let's come to the 6 month strategy. So hardly 6 months left for your prelims. The prelims examination is scheduled on June 27th of 2021. So 6 more months left. So we can split this months into two parts. The first part is Jan, Feb and March. And second is April, May and June. June till 26th. So on 27th you have the exam. So we can split it into two. In the first part, that is in Jan, Feb and March, we will go for a prelims cum mains preparation, because I don't want you guys to leave the mains preparation until the month of March, especially because in the month of February, the budget, the economic survey, such important documents will be released, and it's very important we need to cover these documents, budget and survey, etc. And we have to also make notes also, because it's very helpful for the mains exam as well. So the month of Jan, Feb and March you can dedicate for prelims cum mains. That is, you can also prepare for mains exam. It includes your optionals. When we say mains, it includes your optionals, answer writing, essay practice, etc. So till the month of March you can prepare in a combined way for prelims and mains, but the last 3 months, April, May and June, you have to exclusively give for your prelims preparation. So it should go exclusively for prelims preparation. There is no other choice, but you have to prepare exclusively for prelims, and I'll explain it. So this includes doing or solving prelims questions, mock test. I'll come to the details, okay? I'll come to the details of everything. So prelims questions, then you should have a prelims oriented approach. So a prelims oriented approach, etc. So we will come to it. Now, the 27th of June 2021, this is your D-Day. 27th June. This is when you are going to write the prelims examination. So hardly 6 months left. Now, from Jan 2021 to June 2021, 6 months to go. And as we said, you can split the 6 months into 3 months each. Two pairs of 3 months each. Now, how about the first 3 months of prelims cum mains preparation? So, how you can use the first 3 months? As I said, the months of Jan, Feb and March. These are the first 3 months. How you can use these first 3 months? First thing that you can do is you can cover the basic books. Actually, you must have covered the basic books at least once before this. So what we can do is revision. If you have already covered, you can revise your basic books. Otherwise, you have to put in lot of time and effort, extra time and effort to cover the basic books and make sure you revise, because in prelims, revision is very important. So cover the basic books and then revise. If you have already covered, make this time good for your revision. Second thing is your essay practice. So you can practice your essay maybe one essay a week or one essay per 2 weeks. I would suggest one essay per week. Okay, so you have to continue your essay writing practice for the first 3 months. Next is answer writing. Answer writing, as I always tell you, do write at least one answer a day. One answer per day. You can take questions from various sources and you can try writing. Okay, then in the initial phase, if you are not confident, you can yourself read it and then correct it. But later, when you get confident about your writing, make sure that you give it to someone. It can be your friend also, your mentor, your teacher, anybody. It can be your friend who is also preparing. So get the answer corrected, get the feedback and try to improve the next time. This is regarding the GS preparation. So with regard to GS preparation, in the first 3 months, you can prepare for prelims cum mains, actually, because the perspective in which you prepare the GS for prelims and mains is different. So mains is a little more analytical in nature, prelims is little more specific and factual in nature. So the first 3 months you can actually combine your preparations for both pre and mains. So GS preparation can be that way. Now these are the subjects that you have to cover. Okay, a brief idea about the subjects that you have to cover. Modern India, you have to cover the subject for prelims and mains. Art and culture also for prelims and mains. ancient and medieval India, both for prelims and mains. Now, post-independence. Post-independence is not mentioned in your prelim syllabus. It is exclusively mentioned in your main syllabus. But what we see, the trend that we see in this previous few years is that post-independence questions are being asked. For example, nationalization of banks, the sale of Air India, or nationalization of Air India, and then privatization. Such questions are asked. So post-independence, even though it's mentioned that it's exclusively for mains, I would suggest you that you complete post-independence before your prelims, because you will have an edge over the prelims examination. World history, this is exclusively for mains. Society, it's also exclusively for mains. Geography, it's there for prelims and mains. And these subjects, all of these subjects put together makes your paper 1, GS paper 1 in your mains examination. So these are the subjects for your mains examination paper 1, and most of the subjects, they are repeated, the syllabus is repeated for your prelims as well. Now, next subject is disaster management. This is exclusively for your mains exam. Environment, for both prelims and mains, and especially for prelims, it's a very important subject, because you know Indian Forest Service exam is combined with your prelims exam, civil service prelims. So at least you can expect 20 questions from directly or indirectly from environment and ecology. Then you have social justice, which is a subject in your mains examination in your GS paper 2. Ethics, it is exclusively for GS paper 4 for your mains examination. Ethics, integrity and aptitude. Polity, important for both prelims and mains. In your mains, it comes under paper 2. International relations, again important for prelims and mains. IR is important for prelims and mains. Even though in syllabus it's mentioned for mains, even in prelims you get lot of questions from IR. Security, this is in your paper 3 in your mains examination. Science and technology, both for prelims and mains. And economy also, both for prelims and mains. These are the subjects that you have to study. So these are the subjects that you need to cover. And I'll tell you one more thing. You will get micro syllabus, or you know, each subject divided into micro targets or micro syllabus, what we call as micro targets. So if possible, get a copy of the micro targets and try to cover it that way. It will be helpful. So you can be more specific regarding the goal that you achieve. You can create your micro goals, micro targets, and then try to achieve them. So optional subject, you need at least 3 to 4 months, like 2 to 3 or 4 months, depending on how much time that you dedicate for your optionals. So the next 3 months, that is Jan, Feb and March, you cannot exclusively give for your optionals. By this time, ideally, you should have completed your optional. But it's not that you can simply, you know, leave the optional for now. You can dedicate 2 to 3 hours every day for your optionals till the month of March. So, till March, you have time for optional as well. You can dedicate 2 to 3 hours every day. And when you select your optional, be very sure that these are the things that you keep in your mind. First one is your interest. Definitely, you should have an interest in that subject. The availability of test series, access to study material, the availability of a mentor, and regular quality feedback. So these are the points that you have to keep in mind. Most of the time, I have seen students will simply go for an option just because they like the subject. But when it comes to UPSC, you have to be more professional with your optional. So check that the other factors are also available. I have also seen many students who will go for an optional just because that is a very popular optional, and that the pass percentage or the number of candidates who clear with that optional is high, but the students may not be having the interest. Make sure all these things, all these factors make a balance. Only then go for that particular optional. Next, we will have to dedicate 3 months exclusively for the prelims examination. So for prelims, there should be at least 3 months exclusive preparation, which can start from the month of April. April, May and June, you can dedicate completely for your prelims examination. So what has to be done for the prelims examination. I will say that the key for clearing prelims examination is how deeply you analyze the past year UPSC papers. So remember the point, how deeply you analyze the UPSC previous year papers. It's not just that you go through the previous year papers, but you have to deeply analyze the pattern. You have to understand the mindset of UPSC. You have to understand from your own perspective what the UPSC is expecting from a candidate. So previous year papers, I will say that from my side, I'll say that at least 3 times you have to go through the last 6 years paper. If possible, 10 years. Minimum 6 years. So at least 3 times past 6 years paper, you have to solve it again and again. You have to find out what is in the mindset of UPSC, what UPSC is actually expecting from the candidates. So if you can understand the pattern UPSC is asking, nobody can teach you that. Everybody, maybe mentors or any good teacher can give you a good idea regarding that. But the analysis and, you know, that understanding has to come from your end. So it's very important. You may ask me, is it enough to see some videos which discusses the previous year papers? It will definitely help you. I'm saying that this will help you, but you have to also do it from your end. So previous year UPSC papers, there is no excuse. If you are a serious aspirant, you have to definitely go through the previous year papers again and again to understand the mindset of UPSC. Next is maximum test. So for prelims especially, practice makes the perfection. You have to try and do maximum number of test series. And merely doing the test series is not enough. What is important is to read the answer key and repeatedly revise the points that you make from the answer key. So in test series, you make mistakes, and from that mistakes you should learn. So do maximum number of tests and go through the answer key, and then make it a habit that you revise the notes that you make from the answer key. Now, when you learn the GS subjects for prelims, exclusive prelims, read it from prelims perspective. Now, how do you get this prelims perspective? You get this prelims perspective from the previous year papers, previous year UPSC papers. When you go through the UPSC previous year papers, you will get an idea what kind of questions are being asked and what is the perspective that you should have for your prelims exam. So, this prelims perspective will come only from your reading of the previous year papers. So, GS subjects, keep in mind the way UPSC asks the questions in prelims, and from that perspective, try to cover the GS subjects. Now, a very important question. From the date of prelims to the date of results, what should be done? Most of the cases, you know, there are 3 categories of students after prelims. One category is those students who are sure that they will clear with a high margin. Second is 50-50. They may or may not. Depending on the cutoff and depending on the key and everything, the students will be really confused. And third category, they are sure of failure. That is, they will have very less marks that will not take them to the cutoff. So most of the students, majority of the students fall under the second category. That is 50-50 chance. I may clear, I may not clear. Most of the aspirants, serious aspirants, fall under this category. So what you can do ideally is that do not wait for the results. Just start with your preparation. So just start with your preparation, and in the initial phase, I'll say that go for left out topics. Now, what can be the left out topics? See, we have seen what are the subjects that you have to clear. So there are you have to cover. So there are certain subjects which are needed for both your prelims and mains, which you would have already done for your prelims very well. But there are certain subjects which is only required for your mains. For example, world history, society, then disaster management and ethics paper, security. So these are certain subjects which are needed only for your mains exam. So most of you must have not given much time for these subjects. So I will say that till the date of results, you have to study those subjects. You will get almost 40 days. Normally you get normally you get 40 days, but this year, because of COVID and all, the results were announced very soon. In some 20 days, the results were announced. But normally you get 40 days. So these 40 days or any time that the UPSC gives you before the results are announced, you can study the left out topics. That is, those topics that you have missed for your prelims, that you have not covered for your prelims, or till now, whichever topics you haven't covered, you can go for those topics. very important is answer writing practice. Now, till 3 months before prelims, you were doing one answer per day. But now, after the prelims is over, increase the number of questions that you attempt every day. Do at least 4 to 5 questions every day, and you should be in a position that 1 month before mains, you should be able to write a full exam or a full test in a day. So make sure in the mains exam you have to give 2 papers, one in the morning and one in the afternoon. So make sure at least 1 month before mains you are equipped to write that way, 2 tests or 2 complete tests in a day. So answer writing practice is very important. If you want, you can join for a test series also, because you will get quality feedback. So answer writing practice is very important. Next is revision. Again, even in mains, revision is very, very important. So, if you want to put in some quality content, you have to revise. Revise very thoroughly. Now, let's also see some common things that needs to be followed. Okay. So, this is general things. If possible, try to take a test series for prelims, mains and optional. This is just that you will get quality feedback. So for prelims, I will not tell you that you have to join any test series, because lot number of tests are available online. You can take any of them. Unacademy is also providing lot of free test series. You can join them. For the mains, I will say that it will be better if you can join for a proper test series, because you will have a mentor who will give you a feedback. Then optional, very important that you join a test series. Newspaper reading, it's a part of the preparation. You will ask me, is it enough just to watch the video? If time permits, please go for newspaper reading, because you know, you will understand the points from your perspective. You will have, see, video and all everyone is watching, doesn't make a difference for you or doesn't give you an extra edge. But if you are reading it by your own, you will get an extra perspective from your side. So definitely I will recommend you to go for newspaper reading, paper reading itself. Previous year question papers, at least last 10 years for both prelims and mains. But if time doesn't permit you, minimum 5 years, 5 to 6 years. This is mandatory. You have no exception with that. And with regard to syllabus, be very thorough with the syllabus. You should be familiar with each and every term in the syllabus. And that is also one way how you can prepare your notes and for the exam. So you can take the micro syllabus and then you can prepare each and every term. So syllabus, you should be thorough with each and every term included in the syllabus, and make your own notes, because for revision it's very important, and your own notes will help you, you know, to remember facts and remember the content for a long period, and also it will help you in revision, because many times when we revise, we don't get the time to go back to the basic books and then revise. So if you have your own notes, short notes, it's very important and very good. Then answer writing practice for mains, as I told you, at least one answer per day. Now, if you have a habit of reading, okay, this is not compulsory, this is what I used to do. I do it now also. Whenever I go for a general reading, I mostly like non-fiction. So not fiction, non-fiction. So when I go for a general reading, for example, if I read a particular book, like let's take one very good book that I liked recently is The Cases That India Forgot. That's a book written by Chintan Chandrachud. So that's a book that discusses about 10 of the famous judgments or important cases that India have seen. So whenever I read such kind of general books, what I do is I make some notes, not very lengthy notes, maybe 1, 2 or 3 page notes. How you can use it? You can use them for your essay, because in essay you need to write 1000 words and it requires a lot of content. At least in GS, maybe you are not able to use it, but still you can use it for essay or ethics paper. So whenever you read such general books, especially non-fiction, you get some points, you get some perspective, note it down somewhere. And for mains, you revise it and you can use them somewhere, at least in your essay, in your ethics paper, even for your interview, you can use it. Sometimes in GS also, you can use them. Like for example, some of the Supreme Court judgments, some of the case studies. For example, there is this book called Everyone Loves a Good Drought. So in that book, P. Sainath, it's a book written by P. Sainath. It's one of my favorites. So in that book, he discusses about various cases or various real life examples happening in many parts of India. So such things that you can note down and you can use it as some anecdote or short story in your essay or anywhere you can use it. So make it a habit. If you have the habit of reading general books, then make some notes which can be helpful for your exam. Then if you are only reading for some time, make sure that it's an in-depth reading. You give your 100% into the reading, and revisions are equally important. Revisions are equally important as reading. If you have completed your syllabus, you have just finished the reading of all the books that are required, doesn't make sense at all. Revision is very, very important, or as important as reading. And keep the material very handy and short. I'm sure you must have understood what I mean by this. Many people will suggest you many books for many subjects, but make sure once you select one particular book for a subject, stick on to it and keep the material very handy and short. Otherwise, you are not going to finish the syllabus at all. The syllabus is very vast and there are n number of books available in the market, n number of materials available in the market. So don't go for everything. Keep your material very handy and very short. Another important thing is to collect the key terms, usages, etc. Key terms, like for example, if you are writing an answer, make sure you use some technical terms or some key terms, like for example, soft diplomacy. This is one term that you can use instead of, you know, writing that India can be in friendly relation with other states, other countries. So such kind of technical terms, keywords, usages, etc., you make a collection of them and make sure you add them in your answers. These all will fetch you more marks in the mains. This is for the mains exam. Also, keep a note of quotes, judgments, recommendations, reports, rankings, etc. So quotes, important quotes which you can use for your essay, important judgments of the Supreme Court, High Courts, important recommendations given by important committees. Then the reports like for example Niti Aayog releases certain reports, some rankings like Ease of Doing Business ranking, HDI ranking, Human Development Index ranking for India. So all these, have an idea and keep the notes for all these, because if you read and if you leave it that way, you will forget. So keep a note of all these. Then important committees, multilateral institutions, national institutions, etc. The book summary of the general books that you read. Then important legislations, important acts passed by the parliament. Now in case of legislations, what you can also do is, there are certain legislations, very important, or model legislations that are passed by the state legislature also. Okay, so the Shakti Act in Maharashtra, that is one important legislation. So similarly, there are many legislations which can be model legislations which are passed by the state government. That also you can have a mention. Now map study, it's very important. Map study is very, very important. Even for prelims, map study is important, because map based questions are asked very regularly. So map study is also very, very important. Next is time management. So you must be thinking there is 6 more months left, so we will go slowly with the preparations. Some people may think that there are only 6 more months left, so it may be a kind of tension for them. Both is not good. So you have 6 more months and you have to accept the fact that only 6 more months are left, and you know what are your limitations, you know what are the commitments that you have. Maybe you are a working professional, maybe you have a family, you have your own responsibilities. Not everyone is having full time for preparation. So you know the reality, you know how is your life going and what are your limitations, what are your strength, weakness, everything you know better than anyone else. So manage your time, make micro targets, make small goals and try to achieve them. You know, achieving a small goal itself will give you so much of satisfaction and happiness. So time management is very important. Make maximum use of the time. And one thing that I want to tell you, if you are really, really passionate about your goal, you will find time, you will find space for doing that, for achieving that. So time management is very important. And finally, stay positive and work consistently. Be positive, and there it's not that everyone will have a good time always. There can be ups and downs in life, but stay positive because you have a bigger goal to achieve. So be focused on that single goal. Whatever may come and go, make sure you are the most important person in your life and your goal or your dreams are bigger than anything else. And work consistently. Consistency means you work for a day and you take rest for 3 days. This is not good. Work consistently. Until you reach the goal, you should be restless. So work consistently. And finally, what I want to tell you, suffer the pain of discipline or suffer the pain of regret. Being disciplined, it's painful. You know, you have to forgo many things. Your family, your friends, your enjoyment, maybe movies, maybe going out with your friends, the leisure time that you have, you may have to forgo all of these. It's painful. But you have to decide whether to take up that pain of discipline or to suffer the pain of regret all throughout your life, the entire life. So this choice is yours. Finally, you have to make this decision. And all the best for your preparation, all the best for the UPSC preparations, and Unacademy wants to assure you that we are there with you in this journey, and let's take it together, let's take the journey together, and let's crack UPSC CSE together. Thank you so much for watching, and please hit the bell icon for notifications and use my code JOYCE10 if you are availing any of the courses from Unacademy. And this is once again regarding the biggest discount of 2020. It's a combo offer, UPSC CSE GS plus course plus the optional. It comes at 70,153 instead of the earlier 77,000. UPSC CSE GS iconic subscription plus optional. It comes at 88,705. Earlier it was 97,000. You can apply my code, that is JOYCY10, JOYCY10, and you will get an extra 10% discount. Thank you so much for watching. Stay blessed. Love you all. Bye.